Hello and welcome, my name is Gerry van der Velde and in this video I'm going to show you how you can easily customize your planner cover along with some different ideas on how to make pages for the inside. I'm going to work with the new Slimline planners in this video and let me show you quickly what they look like. They both have a rubber band which makes it easy to close and it's separate so you can take it off completely. The purple one has a matte, smooth, almost velvet-like finish. It has a ring binder on the inside with three sets of three rings. And it comes with a Ziploc pouch where you can add some ephemera or notes or little cards or anything you may want to add or keep with your planner. And then its standard comes with 10 pages out of watercolor paper. The green planner is semi-gloss and it has a bit of leather-like structure. And this is the one I'm going to use to customize. There are also additional planner pages that come in a package with craft, white and black papers. And also in this collection are the new Slimline Edge dies, which will give you the option to make complete pages with a variety of different edges. And then there are the sets with pockets and cards that you can use to create layers in your planner. There's a really simple way to customize your planner. And for that I'm going to use some rice paper. Rice paper is a nice thin paper with some fibers. And you can add it in a very thin layer on the cover of the planner. I'm using the paper from the Warm and Cozy line, which is a perfect fit with the green color. So I've torn the rice paper to get those nice feathery edges. And to add the rice paper, I'm going to use some decoupage lac. And this is the matte version and I'm going to apply it with a soft brush. You can also use a sponge or another tool that you prefer. I'm adding the rice paper upside down to my planner and then I'm going to add the glue. I'm adding the glue in a thin layer all over the rice paper. And this way you don't waste any product and you don't end up with a sticky desk or sticky surface. It's a nice thickness that spreads out very easy without making any stripes, which is perfect for this. Then I turn it over and I add it on top of the planner and I let it land in the middle first. And I don't press it down. I'm going to work from the middle to the outsides using the brush with a bit of the decoupage lac to make it stick to the cover. And I'm brushing it on the rice paper from the inside out. And this will make that those feathery edges go outward, which gives it that really soft look. And if you don't like it, you can also cut the rice paper. That's another option. And you can do it in the same way. Just add it on your planner and work from the inside out. And that way you can make sure that your rice paper is sticking to the complete cover. And because you add it with a brush, the lacquer will also end up on the cover of your planner. And if you don't like it, then just take a wet wipe and wipe it away while it's still wet. Just wipe it outward starting at the sides of the rice paper, so you only take off the bits that landed next to the rice paper. And that will certainly do the trick. And then you can set it aside to dry. And this makes a really pretty front cover. Now the first thing that I have when I see a package like this is I'm wondering what it looks like as a page in paper. So that's what I did. I just cut all the pages with the edges so you can actually see what the different pages look like. Just showing you these pages that you can make is kind of boring. So I thought it would be fun to use some of those papers from the Warm and Cozy line to show you some different options and ways on how you can use the different die sets. I already cut a bunch of the different elements from the scrapbook papers and a planner page. And now I'm going to do some layering. Now this is going to be the base layer for my page. And I cut out the edge with the stars. So I'm just adding some glue to the back. And then I'm going to add that paper slightly from the edge, so a bit of that black is going to show. Next I have that green strip, and I add a strip of black cardstock to the back. And this is going to be a really big pocket. So I've added some tape to the back, and now I'm going to add that part on the left side of the page. So both smaller sides and the long side on the left is taped to the background. Now I have some cards that I cut out of the piece of patterned paper and I can add these in the pocket. And this is just a fun and fast way to make a page for your planner. And when you cut those edges for your pages, then you will get some scraps of course. And being a true crafter, you don't throw anything away. So you can use those scraps, just make them a nice border or an edge for another pocket. I made the base layers the same as for the previous page. And I add a strip that I cut off from another page. I just add that to the edge of the pocket. And then I add some cards in the pocket. And another fun page is done. And for this page I also cut the edge. I've added a piece of patterned paper at the top again. And now I'm going to add another piece of patterned paper with an edge that I cut off at the bottom. And this time it has the opening at the top. So this is another way to get a simple and fun planner page. Another option is to cut some smaller cards and extend them with one of the edges. And this way you can make some tabs in the same style. I think these pages fit perfectly in the green planner. Now let's make some pages for the purple planner. For my next page I cut a piece of scrapbook paper at the same height as a page and a bit smaller so the holes will stay open. Then I cut that scrapbook paper in three using one of the edge dies. And now I'm going to add the top layer to my page. And for the next layers I've got another piece of patterned paper with the same edge die and I'm going to layer those. So I'm going to glue that lightest brown paper to the purple one. And then I'm going to cut off the edges and this goes really well with long scissors. Just line it up to the edge of your paper and then you can trim it off in one take. And then I'm going to use some tape to the back of the paper to add them to the page. For the middle part I only added on the sides and for the bottom part I added along the sides and the bottom. And I just lined them up slightly over each other. To make it easier I first add the bottom one to see if it's in the right place. And then I press down the middle one. And once that is in place I can remove the backing pieces of the tape. And this is another fun page with pockets. For the slimline planners you can also use the 8x8 paper pads. They are not big enough to fit on the complete page, but when you combine them with the pockets and cards, you can make some fun elements for your slimline pages as well. Let me show you a few ideas. For this page I combine a short piece and a long piece from the same color pattern paper. So I create a pocket with a longer piece, like I showed for a previous page. So I just tape that in place on both sides and the bottom and then I can add some cards at the top. And then I can simply add a pocket on top of the big pocket and I can decorate it with an arrow or you can use one of the other elements and finish with another card. Now next thing I want to show you, I had a little bit of a mock-up here. I've used a bit too much glue that made a stain on the black card. Now I could have edited that out, but I wanted to show you how you can fix that. I just cut a tab with one of the colors that's also in the paper, but a bit of a contrast. And this way, when you add that over your stain, it looks like it was part of the design and you did it on purpose. And to make it even more balanced, you can add a little bit of that green at the top as well. And then I just add a bigger panel in the middle with only the long sides taped to the page. And this will give you a big pocket that's open on top and bottom. So you can add a longer card inside or you can add some smaller cards at the top and at the bottom, giving you more fun options to play around with. Mixed paper pad also comes with a bunch of really gorgeous vellum pages. And even though they aren't big enough for a complete slimline page, they are really gorgeous to add in between pages to add a bit of a soft and muted look, letting the next page see through a bit, but not completely. Which will also add to that warm and cozy and give it a bit of a dreamy look as well. Now with that being said, there is a way to adjust the size to make your vellum page fit the size of the slimline pages. So for that I've got two pieces of vellum. One is the 8x8 size from the paper pad with the width of the page. And another one is a strip in the same width. And I also have two pieces of patterned paper. So first I'm going to add one piece of patterned paper to the biggest piece of vellum. Then I line up the small piece of vellum on one of the planner pages so I can get the size right. And then I add the biggest piece on top, lining it up with the planner page as well, sticking them together. And this will give me a longer page. Then I add the other piece of patterned paper to the back to give it a nice finish. And I'm going to add a double layer tab to the side of the strip, cut out of two different colors patterned paper, making this a fun vellum tabbed divider page. So there you have a simple way to customize your planner and a bunch of ideas to make some inside pages. Now these pages are just an idea to get you started. Just go where your imagination takes you and have lots of fun filling up your journal. So make sure to give the video a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. And thanks so much for watching and we'll see you in the next video.